Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. Don't forget, grab your smartphone and download the Lava Matra app and stay in touch. Guru Maharaj's message is your advantage. The following is a Sri Krishna Chaitanya book compilation given by His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Maharaj on July 20th, 2023 in Sridhar, Māyāpur, India.
Hi Krishna dear devotees, today we will continue with the compilation of the Sri Krishna Chaitanya book. Today's chapter is entitled The Way to Awaken Our Dormant Love for Krishna's Lotus Feet. Under the section, the meaning of the Sikshashtaka and how the Lord tasted it himself. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela 20.1.
জাত প্রেম ভক্তরই প্রভুর বিপ্রলম্ব বাপ অনুসরণে যোগ্যতা
Translation Only the most fortunate will relish the mad words of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which were mixed with jubilation, envy, agitation, submissiveness and grief, all produced by ecstatic loving emotions.
Lord Chaitanya was experiencing the love of Radharani and Lord Krishna.
So Lord Chaitanya was experiencing the love of Radharani for Krishna.
And so this love is very elevated and very complicated.
And this love is very elevated and it's very complicated.
And Lord Chaitanya is going deep into the madness of love for Krishna.
Lord Chaitanya was going deep into the madness of love of Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela 20.3
Purite anukkan vipralamba dekul prabhu ei mato mahaprabhu vaishe nila chale Rajani Diboshe Krishna Biraha Vihabbale.
While Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thus resided at Jagannath Puri. So, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thus resided at Jagannath Puri Nilachal, he continuously overwhelmed night and day by separation from Krishna.
So, Lord Chaitanya started his pastimes by chanting Hare Krishna in the Sankirtan Yajna.
So Lord Chaitanya started his pastimes by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra in the Sankirtan Yajna.
And gradually became more and more absorbed in Krishna Prema.
And gradually became more and more absorbed in Krishna Prema. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela 20.4
Prabhur Parampreshta Antaranga Nitya Sangitaye Sharup Ramananda Ei Dui Jana Shane Ratri Dine Rasagita Shloka Ashadane.
Day and night he tasted transcendental blissful songs and verse with two associates, namely Sarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Rai.
These two devotees particularly serving Lord Chaitanya in his extreme ecstasy.
So these two devotees were particularly serving Lord Chaitanya in his extreme ecstasy. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antilila 20.5.
Atti Shaptik Atyatrishti Bevichari Babudai Nana Babute Prabhur Harsha Shukarosh Doina Deya Gadi Utkanta Shantosh.
He relished the symptoms of various transcendental emotions such as tribulation, lamentation, anger, humility, anxiety, grief, eagerness, and satisfaction.
The ecstasy of Kṛṣṇa
The ecstasy of love of Kṛṣṇa
are detailed here.
Lord Chaitanya would enjoy experiencing these ecstasies. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Lila 20.6.
Swayam ba bhaktadaya saha tatta bhava uddipak shlok pat basravan Shei shei bhave nija shlok pariya shloker artho ashadaya dui bandulaya.
He would recite his own verses expressing their meanings and emotions and thus enjoy tasting them with these two friends. Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Lila 20.7.
Kuno dine kuno bhave shloka patan shei shlok ashadite ratri jagaran.
Sometimes the Lord would be absorbed in a particular emotion and would stay awake all night reciting related verses and relishing their taste.
Kṛṣṇa, Chaitanya Mahāprabhu, he would taste the different ecstasies of love for Kṛṣṇa.
So Kṛṣṇa Chaitanya Mahāprabhu, he would taste these different ecstasies of love for Kṛṣṇa.
Sometimes
in love of Kṛṣṇa.
He would absorb himself in one of those ecstasies.
Sometimes he would absorb himself in one of these ecstasies.
Stay out the whole night, reciting verses.
He would stay up a whole night reciting verses. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Lila 20.8.
Prabhu karte shadda sadhan ba upaya upayer abeda varnan. Sarvasreshta or Sarvatut Krishta Charam Abhideya Bashabdi Kavatar Srinam Kirtan Mahatta Barnan Harshe Babu Kahansuna Sarupuramarai Namashankirtana Kalo Paramaupai.
In great jubilation, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "My dear Sarup Damodar and Ramananda Rai, know from me that chanting the holy names is the most feasible means of salvation in this age of Kali."
Lord Chaitanya came to authorize and establish the process of sacrifice of Nama Sankirtan.
So Lord Chaitanya came to popularize and establish the process of sacrifice called Nam Sankirtan. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Lila 20.9.
Krishna Kirtan Kari Ekmatra Shubuddhiman Sankirtan Jagge Kalo Krishna Aradhan Sheita Sumeda Pai Krishna Racharan.
In this age of Kali, the process of worshipping Krishna is to perform sacrifice by chanting the holy name of the Lord. One who does so is certainly very intelligent, and he attains shelter at the lotus feet of Kṛṣṇa, purport by His Divine Kṛṣṇa Prabhupada. For further information, one may refer to Adi Leela, Chapter 3, Text 77-78.
On the 11th candle, Chaitanya predicted and said, Kṛṣṇa will come, but he will be black in color. He will come by his associates, his sciences, etc. And those who follow the system are very intelligent, and they will be bored by people who are very intelligent.
Very bored. So, in the 11th canto, it is explained that Kṛṣṇa would come with his associates and he would propagate the process chanting, and those who follow, they will be very intelligent, and those who will follow them, they will be very intelligent. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Ante Leela 20.10.
Srimad Bhagavatam.
I saw that and I was lost. Oh, Guru Mahārāj is speaking about this and I got completely lost.
Śrīmad Bhāgavat, 11th skandha, 5th adhyāya, ślok nam 30.
Kṛṣṇa varṇam tviṣā kṛṣṇam saṅgho pāṅgāśra pārṣadam yajñai saṅkīrtana prāye yajantīhi sumetasaha. In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the name of Kṛṣṇa. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Kṛṣṇa himself. He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. Jai Guru Mahārāj ki jai. Purport by His Divine Kṛṣṇa Prabhupada, this verse was spoken by Saint Karabhajana in Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32. For further information, see Adi Leela, Chapter 3, Text 52. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Ante Leela 20.11.
Shuddha Namer Phal Nishtrayasa or Kṛṣṇa Pramudaya Nama Sankirtana Haite Sarvanartanash Sarva Shubha Daya Kṛṣṇe Preme Raullash.
Simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Kṛṣṇa, one can be freed from all undesirable habits. This is the means of awakening all good fortune and initiating the flow of waves of love of Kṛṣṇa, love for Kṛṣṇa.
He went to the house of Govardhan and
Haridas Thakur, he went to the house of Govardhan and Malik.
And he wandered there. I said by chanting Hare Krishna, one gets liberation.
The point was that by chanting Hare Krishna, one gets liberation.
But Haridas Thakur said that this is a side benefit.
But Haridas Thakur, he said that this is a side benefit, the Pandit said.
A real benefit, the Lord Krishna.
The real benefit is love of Kṛṣṇa. The Pandit said, by chanting Hare Krishna, one gives liberation. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Ante Leela 20.12.
Sri Muka Nisrita Sri Shikashtak Ba Sri Bhagavat Nirjash Namabash O Namer Phal Paddabalite Dosh Drita Shikashtakar Patam Shlok
Chito Darpanam Ajanam Babamaha Davatni Nirvapanam
Shreyakairava Chandrika Vitaranam Vidyavadum Jeevanam Anandangudivadanam Pratipadam Purnamritasvadanam Sarvatmasnapanam Param Vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam.
Let there be all victory for the chanting of the holy name of Lord Krishna, which can cleanse the mirror of the heart and stop the miseries of blazing fire of material existence. That chanting is the waxing moon that spreads the white lotus of good fortune for all living entities. It is the life and soul of all education. The chanting of the holy name of Krishna expands the blissful ocean of transcendental life. It gives a cooling effect to everyone and enables one to taste full nectar at every step. Purport by His Divine Grace Prabhupada, this is the first verse of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sikshashtaka. The other seven verses are found in texts 16, 21, 29, 32, 36,
39
and
47. Now we go to the Sikshashtaka.
So now we'll go through the Sikshashtaka.
Verse by verse.
Verse by verse.
And it discuss Lord Chaitanya's mood.
It will discuss Lord Chaitanya's mood.
When he chanted the Sikshashtaka.
When he chanted the Sikshashtaka.
So, we would hope that everyone will ask deeply the Sikshashtaka.
So, we hope that everyone would relish the Sikshashtaka.
Prabhupada was saying that Lord Chaitanya, he only wrote these seven verses.
Prabhupada said that Lord Chaitanya, he only wrote these eight verses. Although he glorified the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam,
but he said that everyone, Lord Chaitanya's followers, should know the Sikshashtaka.
So he told that everyone, the followers of Lord Chaitanya, should know the Sikshashtaka.
And it's quite common Guru students to chant the Sikshashtaka in the morning.
So it's quite common for the Gurukul students to chant the Sikshashtaka in the morning.
Well, it's late now. I'll end here and the next days I'll chant the Sikshashtaka.
It's late now. I'll end here and the next days, next day, we'll chant the Sikshashtaka.
First verse of the Sikshashtaka glorifies the chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
So the first verse of Sikshashtaka glorifies the chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Someone told me I was a Sanskrit scholar.
Someone told me who is a Sanskrit scholar. That they studied these eight verses.
And each one is a perfect.
And each one is a perfect.
Composition.
Each one is perfect in its composition.
And that each one got a different meter, a different.
And each one got a different meter and?
It's a different format.
And a different format. Chandas.
or the sense of law is studied and added on the point of view.
So the Sanskrit scholar studied it from an academic point of view.
I found that quite interesting.
I found that and found it quite interesting.
And there was filled with meetings and things.
So anyways, today it was filled with meetings and things.
And
So it became a little late.
So earlier so that we all attend the Mangalarati.
So I'll end here so that you all can attend the Mangalarati. Hare Kṛṣṇa.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.